Hibernation Day. It seems that for me and most of my friends, the one gift that we hope for every Christmas and rarely get is rest. Especially as our families and responsibilities grow, our bodies cry out for it, and we promise ourselves each Christmas season that it is just around the next bend, like the delicious carrot on that cartoon stick. But most of us crash into the new year with the discouraged realization that we are more tired and in need of a vacation than our recent vacationing provided. We long for a day to hibernate, stay inside, and find reprieve from our to-do lists and responsibilities, to allow the slinky toy effect of our existence to recoil, so our soul can finally catch up and once again take residence in our body. A day to be present in the world, quiet and still enough to hear the sound of our one singular life in close quarters with those that we love. In Nashville, where I live, we don't hide from the cold of winter as much as we hibernate in our air conditioning during the brutal summer months to avoid the perma-sweat of 90-degree days and 100% humidity. It is during one of these Freon-fueled inspired hibernations that I write today. Our newborn son is only 2 weeks home, and my wife and I are still happily in the haze of days spent in a fog of coffee and interrupted sleep, with nothing in the world as important as being there for what our son might do next. The pressures of work and the responsibilities of life and friends have been temporarily lifted, and we enjoy our right as first-time parents to simply be where we are and nowhere else. I cannot remember the last time life was so singular and coherent, and I thank God for this reprieve. I know that the responsibilities of life are looming and will be back soon with their lists of demands and expectations. And I am even more aware than I have ever been what courage and determination it takes to truly rest in today's world. This is no small thing, and it only gets more difficult as the years go by. But I hope that this Christmas we can all find the courage to find a day or two to simply hibernate in peace and enjoy the view from inside.